one. Chance, he's giving it away. Easy. What happened then?
Just playing the bat.
Yeah. A little bit too confident, maybe?
No, you know, I was giving you a bit of confidence.
Oh, one goal. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Hi, I'm Ezri Konsa from Aston Villa. You're watching ePL Uncut on the Premier League YouTube.
We're here at Aston Villa ahead of the ePremier League finals, joined by Ezri Konsa and Cameron, the representative for Aston Villa. We're going to be talking everything FIFA. We're going to be playing a bit of FIFA ourselves as well and talking football. First of all, Ezri, you any good at FIFA?
I'm all right, I think.
Yeah?
Yeah, got to be confident.
Definitely. Well, you will have Cameron as your teammate as well, so anything that you do make a mistake on, maybe Cameron will be able to make up for you.
Okay.
First of all, we're going to be asking some questions. We want to get to know both of you a little bit in more detail. Obviously, yourself playing the game professionally, and then for Cameron, virtually as well. Ezri, I just want to say, what is one of the most memorable experiences for yourself as a footballer?
Obviously, making my Premier League debut. That was always a dream of mine as a kid.
Well, they're waiting for the corner, and now they will do the substitution. And Ezri Konsa, a Premier League debut for the youngster.
I was nervous, of course. It was just a moment that was, you know, big for me and my family, and yeah. I just wanted to enjoy it.
That's neatly done from Ezri Konsa. Should be a memorable Premier League debut for him.
I can imagine. And for you, Cameron, obviously competing professionally in FIFA eSports, what's been your highlight so far?
Being qualified this year, adding 21 for Villa, that was obviously a dream. And then probably that top eight last year in FGS3, you know, top eight amongst the whole of Europe, it's obviously a great feeling.
And you're a boyhood Aston Villa fan as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, yeah.
You missed out last year, which was very heartbreaking for yourself.
It was, yeah.
What does it mean to make it this year?
It means everything. Just, you know, I would have been expected to make it last year, so I put a lot of pressure on myself, and I think it got a bit too much during obviously the grand final where I lost. So I thought this time I'm going to approach it like I would with any other tournament we have in the year. And I just did that and then, well, breezed through it, didn't I? So.
Yeah, and you're here now, and that's the main thing for yourself. Yeah. Ezri, Aston Villa, massive club in the Premier League. What does it mean for you to walk out and represent them each game?
It's big. Like you said, Aston Villa's a massive club. Growing up, you hear a lot about Aston Villa. The fan base is amazing. You know, Villa Park, once we walk out onto that pitch, we know that the fans are behind us 100%. We've changed our performances since Unai Emery's coming in.
Yeah.
It's something that we're enjoying and, you know, we're learning every day with him, and it's a process, and I'm sure that the fans can see that as well as us.
And Cameron has the Premier League finals coming up. We'll be competing against 39 other competitors at those finals, obviously on FIFA. Yourself, you've played in some, you know, tight games, stressful games. Yeah. When Cameron walks out there and he's going to be playing his first game on the big stage, what would you say to him? If you were there as his coach, how would you try and keep him calm?
I'd just say enjoy it. You worked hard to get there, so enjoy it and do your best.
So when you're lifting that trophy for Aston Villa, so this is thanks to Ezri Konsa.
that would be good, wouldn't it?
Right then, to start things off, we need to choose our goalkeeper. We have the options of Peter Schmeichel or the current Aston Villa goalkeeper, Martinez.
It's got to be Martinez, isn't it?
Of course, like, yeah.
That's not even a debate, I feel. Four-star week for it as well.
Plays out from the back. He's got the passion. Does his like energy bounce around in the changing rooms?
No, it sure does, yeah. Yeah, we've got a few characters in the changing room and he's one of them.
Well, goalkeeper is set then. We're going to move over to the right back where we have the option of Kyle Walker or Trent Alexander-Arnold.
I'd go Walker. I'd use Walker all year.
Yeah, pace. I mean, in FIFA sometimes you've just got to go for pace, isn't it?
Kyle Walker in at right back then. And then for our centre-back options, we have storyline, Leon Dendonka, or flashback, Thiago Silva.
I'd still go Dendonka. I mean, yeah, so he looks better anyway.
He does.
Yeah, I mean, with you being a Villa fan, and obviously, Enzi playing for Aston Villa, I feel like we might be choosing the Villa players here.
Yeah. Of course, yeah, why not?
Yeah, that's fine.
87 rating. I mean, he's got good stats, so it's nice. Go for the under, yeah.
Now we move over to maybe a bit of more of a difficult decision. Tyrone Mings or yourself?
Got to go you.
Yeah, pace. Look, I'm faster than him in this game, so.
Yeah, higher rating as well.
Higher rating, so yeah, I've gone myself. Yeah. Sorry, Ty.
At left back, we have the option of winter wildcard Andy Robertson or icon Ashley Cole.
Robbo does look better.
Robertson, yeah.
Yeah, we'll go Robbo, yeah.
Yeah. For centre defensive mid, our next option, we are going to have Douglas Luiz or Kamara. At 87 rated.
Yeah, got to be Dougie.
Yeah?
Yeah.
100%.
There you are, in at centre defensive mid. Our next option for right mid, we have rule breaker Leon Bailey, or we are going to look at Buendia. A little bit of difference in ratings there, but.
Yeah, Leon Bailey.
Yeah, pace. He's fast in this game, isn't he?
Actually, what does it feel like on the pitch? Trying to deal with someone like Leon Bailey, maybe in training.
Yeah, it's difficult. When you're coming up against pace, you just got to try and slow them down as much as you can. But when you've got electric pace like Leon's, it's difficult.
Another option, Aston Villa legend. We have got Ashley Young, his flashback item, or Coutinho.
Philip.
Do you reckon? It was a bit slow.
What's Young's one?
Yeah, Young's a lot quicker.
Five-star skill moves with Coutinho there?
When I play FIFA, I don't use skills.
No?
I'm just a possession man and try and finish. It's up to you. This one's up to you.
I remember Young because he was like, when I was like, 4 years old, he was definitely my favourite player before he left United. So.
And our option for centre attacking mid here, he's going to be Robert Perez or Joe Cole.
I'd say Robert Perez.
He's got a bit more of a presence, isn't he?
Yeah.
So, yes. I want to go with that.
And I've heard you like to cross it in every now and then, so maybe Perez would be better in that area than...
Potentially.
...than Joe Cole, yeah. Our striker options now, we have the option of Peter Crouch or Ollie Watkins. So two very different players, right?
I'm going Crouchy.
You going Crouchy?
Well, we've got two strikers, so one, I think Crouchy, because of his height. If you're going to cross the ball and stuff, guaranteed he's going to get a hand of one of them.
But what about the runs in behind?
Ollie's a lot quicker.
It's very different on FIFA when you try to compare it in real life.
Three balls and playing quick is a good way to play.
Yeah, I don't mind. We've got Ollie then.
How are the options? Robbie Keane or Harry Kane?
Robbie Keane.
Yeah, a lot better on the ball, a lot quicker.
Well, there we have it then. That is the dream team for Aston Villa. Let's go ahead and let's put those skills to the test and let's see how both of these players get on against myself in a game of FIFA. Let's go ahead and kick things off then. Ezri and Cameron will be in the home kit of Aston Villa and myself in that away kit. Cameron, what are you watching? Maybe just any tips you want to give to Ezri?
I feel like start with patience, just take your time in attack, defending, don't need to rush anyone out or, you know, make any big mistakes. I mean, so far it looks like he knows what he's doing.
Yeah, I mean, he said he likes possession, so definitely showing that to start things off. For yourself, you've got the Premier League finals coming up. What sort of preparation have you been doing? Obviously, people at home, they may not know what really goes on for a professional FIFA player, how much time they spend.
Oh, God.
Tell you what, I mean, it's early doors. Cameron, and I wasn't expecting to go 4 minutes in. We are going to have forfeits at every single goal. So the forfeit for myself is that I have to make three substitutions, but you two get to decide.
Do you reckon Thiago Silva up front with Robbie Keane?
Yeah.
Yeah, do that. I reckon Harry Kane at right back.
Yeah.
And then we'll do...
Joe Cole, centre-half.
Joe Cole, centre-half.
Yeah, for Dendonga.
For Dendonga.
Yeah.
Brilliant. That is a great start. 4 minutes in, but now you have to change the controller. So Cameron, that's in for you.
Yeah.
Cameron, I still want you to answer that question though. And what's it like building into that preparation for the Premier League finals?
So all I really do is just play lots of practice games against other pro players. There's obviously loads of different pro players from across the whole of Europe. So I just do that for multiple hours a day. And then I analyse all my games, see what I've done well, see what I can do better. Do that every single day leading up to any event I do, but especially for the Premier League, it's obviously the most meaningful event.
Chance.
Look at you play a lot crossing.
I'm easing into it a little bit now. Easing it into it. Ezri, obviously you walked into the room earlier on and you know, you said we're recording with Cameron who represents Aston Villa as a professional FIFA player. For professional footballers, is that something that they're open to? Like they know that this sort of world is out there, that you know, people compete in the actual game?
Yeah, I think the young lads do. I'm not sure about the old heads like Youngie and that.
Thiago Silva. Oh, he's at the post. Oh. Did you see that ball from Thiago Silva then?
I'm getting battered. Yeah, I am. I mean, I need to start leaning forward.
So some of the younger lads, as they've come through, it's kind of something that you've, you know, become more aware of?
Yeah, the young lads, every away trip, they bring their PlayStation, so.
Power shots as well.
Feeling the pressure here, aren't you, eh?
I am, yeah.
Right, let's see if we can grab a goal here and get back into this game. Perez, that little Travella.
Oh. All right, yeah, we trust him.
As you've got big games coming up throughout the Premier League, is there like a pre-match routine that you tend to go for? I mean, myself, and I play FIFA a bit more seriously, I tend to have a good burger maybe and a bit of music.
None of burgers.
No burgers?
No, yeah, just a bit of music, really.
Yeah?
Yeah, a bit of music, a bit of vibes, and that's it.
What sort of music are we talking about?
Any. I'm versatile in music.
Versatile? Okay. Yeah. Like it. Who's the DJ in the dressing room?
Youngie sometimes, me, Leon Bailey, Tyrone Mings. So there's quite a few that we alternate with.
Chance, crossed in, takes it down, Keane.
Ooh.
21 minutes in and it's not looking good for me. Change of controller and it also means another forfeit for myself. I go into ultra attacking, which Cameron, talk us through what actually happens when we go on ultra attacking on FIFA.
So you'll be on constant press, which means anytime we get the ball, your player's just going to fly. And obviously that's going to decrease your stamina as well. And it's the same going like when you're attacking, like every player's just going to go forward and your stamina will get drained. So it can be a good thing, you can win the ball high up, but you're going to be exposed at the back as well.
As you were coming through, when you were developing as a FIFA player, you know, there's multiple different angles people take. You know, some people have coaches, some people practice. Go on, Chance, he's giving it away. Easy. Oh, what happened then?
Just playing about.
Playing about? Yeah. A little bit too confident, maybe?
No, you know, I was giving you a bit of confidence for one goal.
Thank you very much. I needed it. Well, that is now going to be your first forfeit. So if we can please head into the substitutions. So if we could please have Coutinho at centre-back for... I'll take Ezri Konsa off, actually. If we could do Tyrone Mings up front for Watkins.
It's not bad. That's actually not bad, that.
We'll go with Kane in at right mid for Bailey. We're going back to that question. You know, so many people go through different avenues to get better at FIFA.
Yeah.
What's one or two things for you throughout the journey that you go, that's what helped me develop?
Well, when I was a lot younger, I'd always watch a lot of the current pros at that point.
Yep.
I'd look at what I'm doing and then look at what they're doing and try and implement, obviously, what they're doing into my game. And that's obviously helped. And then as I've got further into my career, I've obviously had coaches as well who have, like, really helped out. They just see things that you're not necessarily picking up while you're playing. Having a coach does help massively.
Ezri, do you know that's something that FIFA players have? They have coaches, they have teams that
work with them. I was just thinking that in my head. I didn't know that at all.
Bailey, with that pace, though, takes him on. Chance.
Little bounce back there.
Do you know what? I think as we sat here thinking, this maybe should be the other way around and he should be competing in the ePremier finals right now. Put on a bit more of a show than yourself, Kevin. Maybe it's the pressure, eh? Chance though now. Put the game to bed. It's first to three, remember? I spoke too soon.
That's commentator's curse or something.
Yeah. First to three. Yeah, I mean, you've just sent me to the shops, really, there.
Yeah.
Little ball roll. And that area for pro FIFA players is literally where it's game over, right?
That's where the magic happens. Yeah.
Well, there we have it then. So that is game, set, match, one.